Dear students, we were discussing about mathematical modeling of mechanical translational systems, and we have seen the basic elements of the mechanical translational system. They are mass, spring, and dashpot. So the weight of the mechanical system is represented by the element mass, and it is assumed to be concentrated at the center of the body. And the elastic deformation or the elastic changes, elasticity or the changes in the elasticity of the body can be represented using a spring. That's why in mechanical translational system, spring is there to indicate the elasticity changes. The next one is dashpot, that is used to indicate the friction existing in mechanical system. So what is dashpot? Dashpot is a piston moving inside a cylinder filled with viscous fluid. When a force is applied to a translational mechanical system, it is opposed by opposing forces due to mass, friction, and elasticity of the system. That means when we are applying a force, the mechanical body will offer an opposing force. In this case, there is only mass. Actually, this opposing force will be provided by the mass of the body due to the elasticity and due to the friction. So all these opposing forces will be there against an applied force. So when a force is applied to a mechanical system, the body will be accelerated or moved or displaced in the same direction as that of the applied force. You remember one thing, this is an important point. When we are applying a force to a mechanical system, what happens is that body will get accelerated or moved or displaced in the same direction as that of the applied force. And also the body will exert some forces or some opposing forces against this applied force. And this opposing forces may be due to mass of the body, friction of the body, and elasticity of the body. Okay. So the force acting on a mechanical body are governed by Newton's second law of motion. For translational system, it states that the sum of the applied forces acting on a body is zero. For translational system, the sum of the all forces will be equal to zero. That means applied force will be equal to sum of the opposing forces. Okay, applied force will be equal to sum of opposing forces. And these are the terms that we have already seen. X indicates the displacement, V indicates the velocity, A is the acceleration, F is the applied force in Newton. And these are the opposing forces due to mass, spring or elasticity, and friction. So Fm is the opposing force due to offered by the mass. Fk is the opposing force offered by the elasticity of the body. Fb is the opposing force offered by the friction of the body. M indicates mass. K indicates stiffness of the spring. And B indicates viscous friction coefficient. So now we will look into the force balance equations of ideal elements. So what is the force equations when a particular mass element or when a particular element is alone there? Consider a mechanical system. A force F is applied. So in the same direction, a displacement will be there, and that displacement is indicated using X. Due to the applied force, this mass will exert an opposing force called Fm. So Fm is the opposing force due to mass, and this opposing force will be proportional to the acceleration of the body. This mass Fm, the opposing force due to mass, will be proportional to the acceleration of the body. So we can write Fm is proportional to d square x by dt square. So Fm is equal to capital M into d square x by dt square. And we know that applied force will be equal to opposing force. That's why F is equal to Fm. F is the applied force, Fm is the opposing force. For this particular case, there is no other opposing forces, because we are considering that this is an ideal mass element with negligible friction and elasticity. In this case, there is no opposing force due to friction and elasticity, and we are assuming it as an ideal mass element. In this case, F is equal to, the applied force F is equal to the opposing force Fm, which is equal to m into d square x by dt square. This is the case for mass element. Next is for a dashboard. Here, when we are applying an applied force, when we are applying a force F in this direction, there will be a displacement x, and also as a result, this dashboard will provide or will exert an opposing force called FB against this applied force. F is the applied force, FB is the opposing force due to dashboard. And that will be, that opposing force will be proportional to velocity of the body. This FB, opposing force due to dashboard, will be proportional to the velocity of the body. In that case, we can write FB is proportional to dx by dt. In order to change the proportionality constant, we can write FB is equal to a constant into dx by dt, where FB is equal to capital B into dx by dt. So according to Newton's law of motion, we can write the applied force F is equal to opposing force FB, which is equal to B into dx by dt. You have to write F is equal to FB is equal to capital B into dx by dt. Next is another case. Sometimes there will be displacements at both ends of the dashboard. In that case, here we are applying a force F in this direction. There will be displacement, different displacements at both ends. Here at this end, the displacement is x1, and at the other end, the displacement is x2. In that case, what will be the opposing force FB? In this case, the opposing force FB is proportional to the d by dt of x1 minus xt. Okay, d by, in that, if there is only one displacement, in that case, opposing force FB will be proportional to d by dt of x only. Here there are two displacements, then we can write it is d by dt of x1 minus x2. So in order to change the proportionality constant, now this equation will become FB. Actually, it is FB. FB is equal to B into d by dt of x1 minus x2. Again, we can say the applied force F is equal to opposing force FB is equal to B into d by dt of x1 minus x2. Next is the case of a spring. So consider an ideal elastic element which is negligible mass and friction. This is an ideal spring element which is having no mass and no friction, and we are applying a force F in this direction. The displacement x is also in this direction. The opposing force due to spring K, FK, the opposing force due to the spring is FK, and that will be proportional to the displacement X. So we can write FK is proportional to X. Otherwise, we can write FK is equal to K into X. So the applied force F is equal to the opposing force FK is equal to K into X. Now we will check as in the same case of dashboard, what will be the opposing force due to spring when there are displacement at both ends. So here F is the applied force, x1 is the displacement at this end, and x2 is the displacement at this end. So in this case, the opposing force FK will be proportional to x1 minus x2. Here it is FK, it is not Fm, it is FK. FK is equal to K into x1 minus x2. So we can write F, according to Newton's law, applied force is equal to opposing force Fk, and here Fk is equal to K into x1 minus x2. So these three are the basic force balance equations for these three elements. Now we will discuss the steps to determine the transfer function of mechanical translational system. First, you write down these steps. Because it is these steps should be there in your notebook, then only you can do the problems. So in short, I can tell you that we are going to find out the transfer function of a mechanical translational system. A mechanical translational system will be given, and how will you determine or how will you find out the transfer function of that given mechanical translational system? The only thing now we know is the force balance equations of each of the basic elements. Okay, so in that case, from the given mechanical translational system, we will identify the nodes. Nodes are nothing but the meeting points between the elements. They are the nodes. So each of the node, each nodes will be identified first. Then we can then we know that the linear displacement of the masses are assumed as x1, x2, x3, etc. So first we will identify the nodes. And most of the cases, nodes are nothing but the mass elements. So each of the mass elements, we will assume a displacement x1, x2, x3. If there are three mass elements, x1 is the displacement for mass element 1, x2 is the displacement for mass element M2, x3 is the displacement for mass element M3, and so on. So first we will identify the nodes. Nodes are mass elements. Then for each mass elements, we will identify a displacement, that is x1, x2, x3, etc. And we know first derivative of the displacement is velocity and second derivative of the displacement is acceleration. Then we have to draw the free body diagrams for each of these nodes or each of these mass elements. We have to draw the free body diagram. It is very simple. For each of the masses, we will draw the direction of applied forces and the opposing forces. And we will also indicate the displacement of that particular mass element. So that is the free body diagram. So the free body diagram is obtained by drawing each mass separately and then marking all the forces acting on that node. Okay, so we will draw separately each mass element and we will draw all the forces acting on it, all the applied forces and opposing forces. Always the opposing force act in a direction opposite to the applied force. It's very important. You remember one thing, opposing force will always act in a direction opposite to the applied force. So whatever may be the direction of applied force, all the opposing force will be opposite to that of applied force. If there is no applied force, then the displacement, velocity and acceleration of the mass is in a direction opposite to that of the opposing force. So if there is no applied force, then also we have to mark the displacement. Then we will mark the displacement in a direction opposite to that of the opposing force. Okay, so this will be clear when we will do a problem, it will be clear. And for each free body diagram, write one differential. For each of the free body diagram, we have to write one differential equation. And from those differential equations, we can find out the transfer function or we can find out the input-output relationship of the mechanical translational system. And also, you draw this figure also. So when you come to class tomorrow, you have to write down all these notes and you have to watch this video and I'll teach you how to draw the free body diagram for these two mass elements and how to find out the transfer function of this mechanical translational system. Okay, thank you.